We're now on the site of Bell's Yard, named because they used to ring the handbells to sell the cloth that they woven at the top of them 28 steps in Bell's Yard. So the last handloom weavers, cottages in Colne, were in Bell's Yard. Built in 1752, reign of King George II, and of course, now we are no longer. What we see now is modern Colne. It went demolished exactly 60 years ago. And 20 years after that, I was on this exact same spot with this sign, which was rescued by Colne historian Wilfred Spencer, who tragically died at the age of 56 with five children. And Wilfred rescued this, and his dear widow Helen presented this to me for my Colne collection. So I'm very proud to have this sign. This is the only thing that remains of Bell's Yard. Photographs, we have a few, yes. And there's a famous film, Lancashire Pride, filmed in 1951. And the interior scenes are actually in Bell's Yard. And they have a clog dancer dancing in the middle of Bell's Yard, just below them 28 steps leading to the handloom weavers. So that's absolutely magic. If they'd have kept this courtyard as it was, it went right back there, probably to that grey car there, and it certainly went probably in the middle of Jack Fulton's. So it was a big yard, and at the front were the shops, all the shops on here. There were six streets: Nineveh Street, Parliament Street, Shackleton Street, Clayton Street, St John Street, where Bell's Yard led, and then Railway Street. All bulldozed down from 1959 to 1962. I was working there at the time. In the far door there, that was Elf & Sons, wine and spirits merchant. And I was in the sales and I worked there and I saw them all. And what they did with these six streets, they set them all on fire. They were that old. They were built between 1799 and 1805, all the houses. Bell's Yard was a forerunner to them, as I said, built in 1752, you know. But all these streets were set on fire. It was like Great Fire of London. It was unbelievable. Yeah, I've never seen anything like it before or since in all my years.